Most people think burning visceral fat requires brutal workouts, but that's not really how the body works. Visceral fat is highly metabolically active, and the most efficient way to target it is through zone 2 training, the sweet spot where your cells prioritize fat over glucose. To help you master this indoors, I've broken down 6 science-backed strategies to hit this zone without ever leaving your house. In this video, we'll explore the precision of the stationary bike, the rhythm of controlled jumping jacks, the invisible rope technique, strategic stair-stepping, and intentional high-knee marching. But pay close attention, because I'm saving the 6th strategy for the very end. It is a unique structural approach that solves the biggest problem with indoor cardio, boredom, while keeping your metabolism locked in the perfect fat-burning window. One of the most interesting findings from metabolic research is that moderate, steady-state activity increases mitochondrial function. The more mitochondria you have, and the better they operate, the more efficiently your body burns stored fat, including the dangerous visceral type. Zone 2 is essentially mitochondrial training. Visceral fat also responds to reductions in chronic inflammation. Studies show that consistent, low-intensity exercise lowers inflammatory markers like CRP and improves liver fat metabolism, 2 key factors linked to visceral fat accumulation. You're not just burning calories, you're changing the way your cells behave. And here's the twist most people miss. You don't need outdoor running or long walks to trigger these adaptations. Indoor Zone 2 sessions deliver the same metabolic effect as long as you stay in the right intensity range. Later in this video, I'll show you how to know you're in the correct zone even without a smartwatch. Inside your muscles, there's a quiet shift that happens the moment you enter Zone 2. Instead of relying heavily on glucose, your body begins pulling energy from fatty acids. This switch is measurable in labs through respiratory exchange ratios, and it's one of the clearest signs of efficient fat metabolism. You're essentially teaching your body to prefer fat as fuel. Low switch also activates slow twitch muscle fibers, which are packed with mitochondria. These fibers thrive on oxygen and fat. When you train them repeatedly, they grow stronger and multiply their mitochondrial content. More mitochondria equals greater fat-burning capacity, around the clock, not only during exercise. Another important piece, insulin sensitivity improves. Visceral fat is strongly tied to insulin resistance, and research shows that moderate aerobic exercise is one of the fastest ways to enhance glucose uptake in muscle cells. Better insulin sensitivity means less fat stored around your organs. So yes, Zone 2 may look easy, but inside your body, the engine is doing sophisticated metabolic work. That's why people who stay consistent see real reductions in visceral fat, even if the workout doesn't feel intense. Before we continue, tell me something in the comments. Which indoor Zone 2 exercise do you think would be easiest for you to start with? Your answer helps the channel grow and keeps our conversation alive.
You don't need heart rate charts or lab equipment to know you've hit true Zone 2. The classic marker is the ability to speak in short sentences without gasping. If you can still talk but feel a steady challenge, you're close to the right spot. This talk test has been validated in multiple studies comparing perceived exertion with lactate thresholds. Another reliable signal, your breathing deepens but stays controlled. You shouldn't feel like you're chasing air. When breathing becomes choppy, you've likely drifted into Zone 3, which prioritizes glucose rather than fat. Staying just below that shift is where your body burns the most visceral fat. You'll also notice a gentle warmth, not the overwhelming heat of high-intensity work. It's subtle, like your body is quietly turning on its internal furnace. This is a natural response to increased fat oxidation. If you want an even simpler cue, pay attention to your stamina. In real Zone 2, you should feel like you could keep going for a long time. If you crash early, you probably push too hard. In the next sections, I'll show you indoor routines that naturally keep you in this range.
A surprisingly effective trick to stay inside zone 2 is to anchor your pace to your breathing pattern. Researchers studying endurance athletes found that stable nasal or controlled oral breathing helps regulate intensity and avoid accidental spikes. When your breathing stays smooth, your heart rate usually follows. Try breathing in for 2 counts and out for 2 or 3. This simple rhythm encourages a steady aerobic pace. If you notice the urge to breathe faster, it's a sign you're creeping out of zone 2. Adjust your movement instead of forcing your breath. Continuous breathing also supports vagal tone, the part of your nervous system that keeps your heart rate calm and stable. Better vagal tone means smoother transitions in and out of effort, which helps maintain fat-focused metabolism rather than triggering stress-driven glucose burning. Many people underestimate how powerful breathing can be in exercise, but for zone 2, it's one of the cleanest ways to guide your body without equipment. You'll see this technique appear again in the indoor routines coming up. Indoor sequence 1, stationary bike with a scientific setup. A stationary bike is one of the easiest indoor tools for zone 2 because you can adjust intensity with precision. Start with light resistance and a cadence that allows you to speak comfortably. Scientists studying cycling metabolism confirm that low resistance combined with steady cadence maximizes fat oxidation. The goal isn't to chase speed, it's to stay in a sustainable rhythm. Keep your shoulders relaxed, grip loose, and pedal smoothly. Tension in the upper body can artificially elevate your heart rate, pulling you out of zone 2 without realizing it. As the minutes pass, pay attention to how your breathing settles. You're looking for that "I can do this for a while" feeling. That's where your body begins tapping into visceral fat stores more actively, thanks to steady aerobic demand and improved mitochondrial engagement. If you don't have a bike, don't worry. There are several other indoor sequences coming up that work just as well in small spaces. And stick around, because halfway through the video, I'll ask you a question to keep our conversation going. Indoor sequence 2, moderate jumping jacks for long duration. Jumping jacks don't look like a zone 2 exercise at first glance, but when performed at a controlled, moderate pace, they fit perfectly into the aerobic fat-burning window. The key is to avoid explosive speed and instead maintain a smooth, repetitive motion. Studies on steady-state plyometrics showed that when intensity is moderated, the body leans heavily on aerobic metabolism. Your breathing should deepen gradually, not spike. If you start feeling breathless within the first few minutes, slow the tempo. Zone 2 isn't about power, it's about consistency. This controlled rhythm nudges your muscles to rely more on fat oxidation rather than glucose. Another advantage of jumping jacks is that they use both the upper and lower body, which distributes the workload and reduces early fatigue. When more muscle groups contribute gently, the cardiovascular system maintains a stable demand, ideal for sustaining zone 2 without drifting too high. If space is limited, shorten the lateral step distance. What matters is the continuity of movement. Keep your posture upright, land softly, and aim for a pace that feels sustainable. By the way, as you're watching, which of these indoor exercises do you think would fit your routine best? Leave your answer in the comments later. This helps the channel grow and shapes future videos. Indoor sequence 3. Invisible rope skipping in tight spaces. You don't need an actual rope to get the metabolic benefits of rope skipping. The invisible rope technique avoids tripping, saves space, and still provides the rhythmic bouncing motion that researchers associate with improved aerobic capacity. Keeping the jumps low and controlled helps stay squarely in zone 2. The magic of this exercise lies in cadence. Light, repetitive hops stimulate the stretch-shortening cycle of your calves without overwhelming them. This movement pattern supports steady oxygen use, which keeps fat oxidation active. You should feel light, not explosive. Your arms should make small, circular movements to mimic rope rotation. This subtle upper body involvement helps regulate pacing because it discourages sudden bursts of speed. As long as your breathing remains smooth and conversational, you're in the right range. If your joints feel sensitive, switch to alternating foot hops instead of two-foot jumps. This reduces impact while maintaining the aerobic stimulus. Many people underestimate how effective this low-space routine can be, but physiologically it behaves similarly to moderate outdoor jogging without ever stepping outside. Indoor Sequence 4. Improvised stair work that activates metabolism. Stair climbing is a metabolic powerhouse, but full flights aren't necessary. Even a single step or low platform can replicate the effect when used rhythmically. Research shows that stepping exercises, when kept at moderate intensity, significantly increase oxygen consumption and fat oxidation rates. The goal isn't height, it's pace control. Step up, step down, and repeat with a tempo that allows steady breathing. You shouldn't feel a heart rate surge. A common beginner mistake is using steps that are too high, which pushes the workout into glycolytic intensity and breaks the zone 2 profile. Your quadriceps and glutes do most of the work here, but because the motion is repetitive and predictable, your cardiovascular system adapts efficiently. Over time, this routine improves both aerobic capacity and insulin sensitivity, two key factors linked to visceral fat reduction. If balance is a concern, keep one fingertip lightly on a wall or chair. Stability allows you to maintain rhythm without spikes of effort. The beauty of this exercise is its simplicity: one step, a controlled pace, and consistent movement. Indoor Sequence 5, Controlled High Knee Marching. High knee marching can be an excellent zone 2 tool when done slowly and deliberately. Instead of the fast, high-intensity version seen in HIIT workouts, this variation focuses on controlled elevation of the knees while keeping posture relaxed. Think of it as walking in place with intention. This movement elevates heart rate just enough to enter zone 2 while keeping impact minimal. Research on low-impact aerobic drills shows they can significantly improve cardiorespiratory function when performed at sustained moderate intensity. This makes high knee marching suitable for people with joint concerns. The key is rhythm. Lift the knee, place the foot down softly, and alternate without rushing. Your breathing should remain stable. If you feel your shoulders tense or your breathing quicken suddenly, dial the pace back. You are teaching your body to burn fat calmly, not through stress. This method is especially helpful for people who can't use bikes or steps indoors. It requires no equipment and very little space, but when done for long intervals, it engages the hip flexors, core, and legs in a balanced, sustainable way. Indoor Sequence 6, a mini circuit that maintains zone 2 without spikes. A mini circuit is a smart way to avoid monotony while staying inside the zone 2 range. The trick is choosing movements that keep your heart rate stable rather than explosive. Cycling through slow bodyweight squats, gentle marches, and controlled sidesteps creates a seamless flow. Each exercise should be performed at a conversational pace. Studies on aerobic circuit training demonstrate that low-intensity, multi-movement circuits can improve mitochondrial density just as effectively as continuous single-movement exercise, as long as the intensity remains moderate. Rotate every minute or two. This prevents local muscle fatigue, which can artificially spike intensity, and helps maintain fat oxidation levels. The goal is comfortably challenging, not breathless. Your breathing should be smooth the entire time. This format is particularly useful for people who get bored easily with repetitive cardio. The circuit structure keeps the mind engaged while the body stays solidly in the metabolic zone that reduces visceral fat. If you enjoy variety, this one will feel natural. Many people assume zone 2 is simply easy exercise. But the biggest mistake is accidentally slipping into a higher intensity. It often happens when enthusiasm kicks in and the pace increases just a little too much. The problem is that once you cross into zone 3, the body shifts toward carbohydrate dependence, which reduces the fat oxidation effect you're aiming for. Research on metabolic crossover points shows that even small jumps in intensity can dramatically change fuel usage. That means a tiny increase in speed or resistance might feel harmless, yet it shuts down the very adaptations that improve visceral fat metabolism. Your goal is metabolic precision, not speed. Another subtle error is upper body tension. Tight shoulders, clenching your hands, or lifting your chest too high can increase heart rate unintentionally. These shifts may seem minor, but physiologically they nudge you out of the fat-dominant zone. Relaxation is a skill in Zone 2 training. The solution is simple awareness. Check your breathing every few minutes, feel your posture, and ask yourself whether the effort still feels sustainable. If you notice creeping intensity, just adjust. Zone 2 is forgiving, as long as you stay honest with the signals your body gives you. If this video is helping you understand how real fat-burning physiology works, consider sending a super thanks. It supports the channel and allows me to bring more science-based content like this. Zone 2 is one of the safest ways for people with overweight or joint discomfort to improve metabolic health. Studies consistently show that low-intensity aerobic training reduces visceral fat while putting minimal strain on joints. The structure of Zone 2 protects cartilage by avoiding the impact spikes seen in high-intensity routines. For those with knee or hip pain, movements like slow marches, step-ups with low height, and stationary cycling tend to be the most joint-friendly. These activities distribute load more evenly and allow the muscles to support the joints rather than overloading them. Consistent practice can also improve mobility and coordination. If balance is an issue, perform the exercises near a wall or stable object. Stability is important because sudden compensations can unintentionally increase intensity, exactly what we're trying to avoid. A smooth, predictable movement pattern keeps you in the correct physiological range. One more point backed by research. Improving insulin sensitivity is especially beneficial for individuals carrying excess visceral fat. Zone 2 training does this remarkably well. Even short, regular sessions can produce meaningful changes, making it a sustainable, science-supported path for long-term health. Visceral fat doesn't change overnight, so tracking progress requires patience and the right indicators. One reliable method is monitoring waist circumference. Researchers often use this measurement because reductions around the abdomen correlate strongly with decreases in visceral fat. Another indicator is how easily you can maintain Zone 2 over time. If you notice you can sustain longer sessions with stable breathing and lower perceived effort, that's a sign your aerobic system is improving. Better mitochondrial efficiency indirectly signals improved fat metabolism. You can also track resting heart rate. As your cardiovascular system adapts to regular Zone 2 work, resting heart rate gradually decreases. This shift is associated with improved metabolic health and often accompanies reductions in visceral fat. And finally, pay attention to how your energy feels throughout the day. People who consistently train in Zone 2 often report more stable energy levels because the body becomes better at using fat for fuel. It's a subtle but meaningful sign that your internal physiology is shifting in the right direction. If you enjoyed this video and want more science-based explanations without the hype, make sure to subscribe, like, and share this video. It helps the channel reach more people looking for real, evidence-based health guidance.